गुड मॉर्निंग लिसनर्स ऑन आकाशवाणी रेडियो 106.5 FM एंड ऑन वर्ल्ड वाइड वेब आकाशवाणी रेडियो .co.tt. दिस इज योर फैमिलियर वॉइस ताउशो बुद्धा स्पीकिंग टू यू ऑन ऑल दैट यू नीड टू नो अबाउट योर फूड इंग्रेडिएंट्स, योर फ्लावर, द कुकिंग मीडियम, spices. We are coming to you with the compliments of Swarna whole wheat flour and Deep stone grind whole wheat flour, Surabhi and Lakshmi coconut oil, Shrigun blend of spices, Deep foods. Khao to jaano. You know only when you eat, only when you taste, a quality that you can never miss. And soon we are introducing the wide range of samosas, naans and various other items. This is a program to educate you about various ingredients that you like to put on your table. Remember, food is our fuel. Just as a gas dependent car splutters and comes to a stop, if we are putting cooking oil into the gas tank instead of premium gasoline, our bodies get blockages and diseases. If the food is not of optimum quality, instead of the good quality fat, if you put trans fat, which is a vast range of cooking oils available on the supermarket shelves, they are partially hydrogenated, and not only that, they create trans fats in your body. It's something like that, the fat settles and clogs your arteries and becomes a problem. So it is very significant what kind of oil you are putting. You are very intelligent. You do not put the engine oil in your gas tank. You seem to be very intelligent. When it comes to food, why you don't use that intelligence? Know about your foods, the flour, the stone grind flour, which naturally preserves the qualities. It preserves the wheat germ, it preserves the wheat bran and the natural qualities which are maintained, which are reserved. And it is for that reason I use stone grind whole wheat flour. We have two brands, Deep whole wheat flour, stone grind, that promotes your cardiovascular health, and Swarna Chakki flour, naturally good and stone grind. You can use this to make your rotis. Just knead the flour, no baking powder is needed. It is self-raising. You can make your basabshat. It comes out very rich and satisfying. And not only that, it is good for your health. You can use this to make your whole wheat bread. Not that you have to add molasses to color the bread or add bran. This is naturally good and makes a very healthy bread. You can add rolled oats, you can add other things, and now American Bakers Association is using sorghum flour. Sorghum in Hindi is known as jowar flour. Deep product, this jowar flour, is also available in the supermarket, Naipaul's Extra Food, Grand Bazaar, and Prem Singh's Puja Bhavan in Kurip. Ayurvedic sages knew that food is our medicine. Eating the right food at the right time in the right quantity makes a person healthy, wealthy and wise. According to Ayurveda, the food is complete only when it has all the six tastes, the sweet, the salt, sour, hot or pungent, bitter and astringent. If the food is combined with all these tastes, it works on various doshas that are there in the body. And there are two types of foods, the East Indian food and the Thai food. They understand the idea behind the amazing ways in which it is prepared by blending various tastes. Most of the dishes in the Thai restaurant usually have a majority of these flavors, and the East Indian food too has the blend of these six flavors. That is why such foods are tasty and also satiate your taste buds. The balance of these flavors makes us satisfied and less amount of food. You are satisfied with less amount of food. That is because our body is satiated and we feel content. On the other hand, food in many countries lacks most of these flavors, except sweet and salt maybe, and maybe the pungent, the pepper. And people tend to continue eating without feeling satiated. This is the major reason for obesity that we see all around us. So in today's program, I will speak about the coconut oil, its composition, and the blend of spices. First, let me speak of the spices and then I'll come back to you about the coconut oil. Of course, when it comes to spices, I am coming to you with the compliments of Shrigun blend of spices, naturally healthy, tasty, hygienic, and fragrant. There are six basic emotions or inner functionings, often referred to as demonic vices, when these are not purified. In their unpurified form, these are known as demonic vices. These are kaam, sex or desire, krodh, anger, lobh, greed, moh, passion or attachment, mad, ego, and matsar, jealousy. You may wonder what is the relation between these emotions and the spices. Certainly there is a subtle relation between the two. Each of these emotions aggravate a particular physical and psychological condition in the body. These manifest at body-mind level as disease of a simple or complex type. When these emotions are sanctified, then the fragrance of the being manifests as awareness that becomes your understanding, bliss and harmony. And each spice or herb acts as the antidote for one or a group of these emotions. Therefore, herbs and spices form an important ingredient of our daily life. Each herb and spice has certain medicinal qualities as well. Therefore, from early part of human civilization, herbs and spices have been grown, harvested, traded, and consumed both as medicine and as part of culinary delights. Such has been the understanding of the ancient sages and masters. Out of this awareness emerged the special blend or technique of combining these spices and herbs as integral part of our day-to-day life and living. Shrigun spices are the epitome of this particular understanding and blending of various spices so that all the six essential digestive juices are secreted in your body when the food is consumed. Very naturally, we have a habit of chewing a gum. You know what happens? Are you aware what happens when you are chewing gum? A false indicator goes to the stomach because you are chewing. A process of chewing is going on, and with that, the juices, the digestive juices, are secreted in the body. This is a false notion. The stomach reacts. It is directly connected to your chewing. The moment the process of chewing begins, digestive juices are released. And all the digestive six juices are released. But when you are eating the food of one particular or blend, then some of the juices are consumed in the process of digestion. But what happens to the others? They remain unconsumed in the body and creates many kind of ailments. We do not establish any connection between the two because we are more concerned with the outer world, the knowledge of the outer world. We know about politics, we know everything about the outer world, but how much do we know about our inner mechanism? The food that we consume, it is very important. And Sri Guna spices, naturally hygienic, good, fragrant and tasty. And what happens there, each particular food item that you consume, it has certain qualities. For instance, you want to use sugar. Sugar is harmful because it creates an imbalance between the body level of sugar, insulin level. Now, if you do intend to consume, then you must know the antidote. The antidote of sugar is cinnamon. So if you are consuming too much sugar, then you must take after the food a cinnamon tea. It antidotes. So when you are eating a fish, it has certain good qualities, certain bad qualities. How are you going to create the antidote in it? If you do not know about your spices, how are you going to blend? So when we are cooking fish, we must use fennel or aniseed in it as a spice. That spice blend must have aniseed to counteract the negative elements of it. And then its benefits are optimized. Otherwise, the same food creates the indigestion in you. When we use pulses, the beans, they are very rich in protein, and that protein contains the nitrogen element. Nitrogen is hard to digest. So when you eat the beans, it creates the problem. So how to use the antidote? Then asafoetida or hing, a pinch of that, a very small quantity of that, when is used at a particular time while you are preparing the pulse, the beans, it creates an antidote. It breaks nitrogen into a complex, into a simple digestible element. Then you do not get the problem of indigestion. These information, this understanding is very essential in combining the blend of spices. Earliest mention of these herbs and spices we traced in Hindu scripture like Ramayana and Vedas. Atharved is entirely dedicated to the sacred knowledge of these herbs and spices. Still, one can find traces in Rigveda, Shushrut Samhita and Chakra Samhita. These are two Ayurvedic scriptures. These are replete with descriptions and the curative properties of these herbs and spices. Some of those are mentioned in these scriptures are not found in India. However, blending of cultures and migration exposed humanity to more than 500 spices, different variety of herbs and spices. Chinese have introduced nearly 1,000 herbs. Those descriptions date back to 2500 BC, and such descriptions are found in Chinese encyclopedia, Yellow Emperor. Hippocrates, the Greek physician, who is known as the father of modern medicine, has also listed hundreds of herbal varieties. All taken together bear ample testimony to the significance and importance of the use of herbs as cure for ailments. As man evolved, his ingenuity allowed him to explore all that nature has in treasure. In the old days, herbs were collected from forests, hilltops, plains, and riverbeds, as these grew there. But there was no organized effort to grow these. These herbs were used both for medicinal purposes as well as to flavor the food and delight in cooking. Almost all the civilizations and culinary styles use herbs and spices to varying degrees. However, Indians have used these herbs and spices more comprehensively than any other civilization. Each herb has flavor, medicinal quality, and taste. However, when these are used as combinations, complementing one another, the value of such combinations is enhanced manifold. Besides Indians, no other culinary style have exposed these combinations so intensively. I admire the ingenuity in creating special combinations for special vegetables and meats. Like we have a special blend for chicken, a special blend for fish, a special blend for other meats, then for vegetables, dals, for biryani, which is a complete meal. And it was introduced during the Mughal period for the army, for the soldiers. It has, you can cook a chicken biryani, a lamb biryani, a vegetable biryani. It is a complete meal filled with protein, blend of spices and the carbohydrates, and it has fresh vegetables too. So it becomes a complete meal, and that was given to the soldiers so that there is not too many things to be given. Now when you look at the plant has three things. Number one, it has the stem, it has the roots, and it has the leafy part. The leafy part of the plant is known as herb. Sometimes the stem part is also forms the part of herb, whether it is fresh or it is dehydrated. Then comes the root part. The root part of it or the fruit part of it is known as a spice. A fresh coriander leaf is known as herb, and dried seeds are known as a spice. The cumin seed, it is the seeds of it. Now when you look at turmeric, it is the root that is used as a spice. Its leaves, we have not found the much use of the leaves explored as yet. So naturally the herbs and spices are categorized into three categories. Basic spices, then the basic spices, the category includes chili peppers, coriander, turmeric, cumin seed, and mustard seeds. These are bases. The onion seeds, which is also known as kalonji, is also formed part of that. Then there is a next category known as aromatic spices. These basic spices are used in abundance. Aromatic spices are used as trace elements: clove, nutmeg, cinnamon, cardamom, red cardamom, bay leaf, mace, asafoetida. These are the aromatic spices. Then there is curry leaves, which is also forms the part of herb. Then there are ornamental spices like poppy seeds, black dill, the white dill, coriander leaves, mint leaves. These spices in the various blends are available on the supermarket shelves at Prem Singh's, Puja Bhavan and Naipaul's Extra Food. I will continue the talk on this in the subsequent program. Let me speak on the coconut oil. The health authorities, and when it comes to coconut oil, I am coming to you with the compliments of Surabhi cooking coconut oil and Lakshmi brand of cooking coconut oil, available in Naipaul's Extra Food Grand Bazaar and Arima branches and Prem Singh's Puja Bhavan, Q-Rep and Shagwanas. The health authorities worldwide recommend that the consumption of trans fat be reduced to trace amounts. Trans fats from partially hydrogenated oils like your margarine and various such products, these are trans fats, and these are partially hydrogenated. They are harmful than naturally occurring oils. Two Canadian studies that received funding by the Alberta Livestock and Meat Agencies and Dairy Farmers of Canada have shown that naturally trans fat found in beef and dairy products can have opposite health effect and can naturally be beneficial compared to hydrogenated vegetable shortenings or a mixture of pork and soya fats, lowering total LDL cholesterol and triglyceride levels. Unsaturated fat is a fat molecule containing one or more double bond between the carbon atoms. Since the carbons are double bonded to each other, there are fewer bonds connected to hydrogen. So there are fewer hydrogen atoms, and it is named as unsaturated fats. Saturated means the carbon has the two bonding, and so on the either side it should be connected. If you have a pot that have only one handle and the handle is small, it is difficult to lift when it is hot. It's supposed to have the operating handles on the two sides. So carbon must have the hydrogen attached to it like the two handles on either side of the pot. And it is for that reason that we use the saturated fatty acids. Unsaturated fat is a fat molecule containing one or more double bonds between carbon atoms. Since carbons are double bonded to each other, there are fewer bonds connected to hydrogen. Hence, it is known as unsaturated. CIS and trans are the terms that refer to the arrangement of two hydrogen atoms bonded to carbon atoms involved in double bond. In the CIS arrangements, the hydrogens are on the same side of the double bond. In the trans arrangement, the hydrogens are on the opposite side of the bond. Coconut oil is naturally hydrogenated. It is a good quality fat that your human body needs, your brain cell needs. And also the clarified butter, which is known as ghee in the Hindi terminology, is also good for human consumption. We are coming to you with the compliments of Surabhi and Lakshmi brand of coconut oils. Both coconut oils are good for cooking. Of course, what I did, I put a bottle of Lakshmi coconut oil in my fridge and it froze. I scrape up every morning, I stick off the coconut oil which is solidified and use it like chocolate stick. And the same way I use every morning, either I stick off butter or a stick of clarified butter, that is ghee, in the morning as my medicine before I take my breakfast. You too can use that. These products are available at Prem Singh's Puja Bhavan in Curep. The telephone number is 663-2494 and Naipaul's Extra Food telephone number 662-8151 in Grand Bazaar. And if you are in the southern area, you can call Vishnu 337-3785. In Pinal area, he carries the coconut oil and the flour. Only this much for this morning. I am thankful to you for being such a patient listener, and make sure that you tune in to your radio station next week when I am coming with another set of useful information, tips and many other things. And in times to come, I will give you recipes also. Whatever I have spoken this morning on the spices is part of my book, Cooking Taosho Buddha Way, Volume 1. I have certain copies available with me. For any further information, you can call me at 683-8587. This is Taosho Buddha signing off for this morning. Thank you and do have a blessed day.